my Tai Chi is the Yang style, and this is the warm-ups for it. The idea is to stretch the back in all four directions. And so I start with a little back stretch, very easy. And just to get a little stretch in the back, as you can see from sideways, very comfortable. And of course I do this every day, so it keeps me very limber. So I stretch it back, and very important is I turn it from side to side, which develops the waist. And also notice I'm doing it very gently. You don't have to do this hard. If you do it every day, you will get a tremendous, develop a tremendous freedom in the waist and in the back. And this is what helps you to do all the everyday work or things you want to do at home without any pain or discomfort. This keeps your waist muscles in shape. And in Tai Chi, the waist is the source of the power. If you want to do it a little bit easier than having your arms out here, which is a bit stressful on the shoulders, but it builds up the shoulders, is to do it this way and keep your nose right between your fingers. And to help you concentrate on doing it from the waist, you do it this way. It's easier on the arms. And you keep looking right between the two hands. So it guides you better on how to turn the waist. In other words, I'm not moving from the arms. I'm moving from the waist. And then whenever you feel like it, if you wish, you can open up the arms, which gives you a little bit more exercise and strengthens the arms a little bit more. But it's basically still for the waist. And if you don't do the forearms, at least do this little warm-up and you'll feel much better. And the final part of it is to do a simple toe touch. And the toe touch is to bend the spine forward. We do that by going down from the top of the spine down to the bottom, and then we come up from the bottom of the spine to the top. And the arms and the neck, very relaxed. So going down, I start with the head relaxing. And from the upper back, I start going down. Notice the arms, very loose. And feel each vertebrae, so that each vertebrae gets a stretch and all the muscles and nerves around it get stretched. And don't push, just relax. And it takes a few seconds for the body to relax all the muscles, and you'll be able to go down very comfortably. Don't push it, do what's comfortable. And if you do it regularly, you will go further down, and naturally. Don't have to force it. And I don't rush this. I do this with plenty of time, because it's very important for the back muscles. And check your neck. Check your back of your knees can be bent a little bit, or you can straighten them as you feel comfortable and as the stretch improves. And you should feel no pain, no difficulty at all. If you don't feel it now, if you don't feel any pain now, you will not feel any pain when you're moving around during the day. Like I said, I give this a good solid minute, or sometimes even longer, 2 minutes. And also to let the heart pump blood upside down a little bit is very good for the circulation of the heart. And I come up very slowly from the bottom of the spine. And I try to feel the vertebrae, and also I stretch the hamstring muscles up here and straighten the knees. Again, all very, very gently coming up. My knees
slightly bent maybe. Just feel comfortable. And come up very slowly so that I feel absolutely no discomfort on the way up. Relax my neck again. And this really gives the back muscles adjacent to the spine and the vertebrae a very good stretch. And you can feel it. The slower you go, the better. Because you can feel the body's weight stretching this part, which ordinarily in our everyday activity, we don't really stretch it. We just have certain fixed movements and we get very used to them, which is why when we try to do something a little bit more, we sometimes hurt ourselves. But the Tai Chi helps to stretch the whole range of movement. And so you can move around really pain-free. And that, as you might appreciate, is a blessing. So you come up and just stretch out comfortably. And that's really it. After this, your body is much more ready to do the particular Tai Chi form or anything else that you might have to do. And of course, good posture is also very important. Absolutely straight. And the spine, the hips turned in slightly so that your back and your spine is straight to the bottom. And you feel the balance of the weight right in between, in the middle of the 2 feet, about shoulder width. And that's my favorite, relatively short Tai Chi warm-up. Thank you.